It was the end of a busy day on the island of Sodor, and Thomas was on his way to Titmouth Shed's western top of Hack MCM at Nafford Station. He had a special surprise for Thomas. Thomas, there's a lot of boys and girls who want to see you in Blowing Rock, North Carolina. The manager of Tweetsie Railroad has sent me this invitation to invite you for a day out with Thomas this summer, said Sir Topham Hatt. So I had decided that you will go there because you deserve it and you've been working extra hard too. Thomas was delighted.
Thank you, sir. I can't wait to go to Tweetsie Road to give train rides,
said Thomas. He was very excited. When Thomas arrived at the shed, his friends were very happy for him, even Percy. While Thomas is away, I need someone to look after his branch line.
I'll do it, sir, Percy whistled.
He was happy to help his best friend.
Excellent! Thank you, Percy.
So the next day, Thomas went to the washdown, where he was being cleaned up and polished, until he was shining in the morning sun, and he was filling his coal bunker with coal and his tanks with water. As Thomas arrived at Nafford Station, his friends were there to say goodbye.
Have fun in America, Thomas.
Thanks, Toby. I will.
I promise I'll take care of your branch line, Thomas.
Thank you, Percy.
Goodbye, Thomas, and be a credit to our railway.
I will, sir.
Smile, Thomas. Then it was time for Thomas to go to North Carolina as he pulled out of the station. Everyone cheered as Thomas was out of sight.
Next stop, Tweetsie Railroad. Good times ahead,
cried Thomas as he raced down the rails. As Thomas came around the bend, there was trouble.
Uh-oh, look! The trucks are closed for repairs!
Oh no!
Cried Thomas.
How will I get to Tweetsie Rambo now? I have to be there soon or I'll be late!
Don't worry, Thomas. I'm sure we'll find a way. Then, Thomas saw a shortcut. It goes to Tweetsie Railroad.
but it's a big climb for Thomas.
Maybe we can take this track,
he said. But the driver wasn't so sure as Thomas went through the shortcut. The track goes uphill and it was hard work, but Thomas didn't give up. You can do it, Thomas, encouraged his driver. Thomas puffed and puffed with all his might. At last, he arrived at Blowing Rock, North Carolina.
Hooray! I made it!
Nice job, Thomas, cheered his driver.
Now let's get to Tweetsie Railroad,
chuffed Thomas, and he pumped his pistons as fast as he could. He arrived just in time as the children cheered for him.
Bust my buffers! I finally made it to Tweetsie Railroad!
You're excellent, Thomas! Sir Topham Hatt will be so proud of you for not giving up, added the fireman. Thomas beamed from buffer to buffer, and he was very excited to be at Tweetsie Railroad for a day out with Thomas. Thomas parked into the engine shed, where he met an engine.
Hello there,
the engine whistled.
You must be Thomas. We were expecting you.
It's great to be here,
said Thomas.
My name's Tweetsie,
said Tweetsie.
I'm going to need your help to give train rides tomorrow for the big day.
Don't worry,
smiled Thomas.
That's why the really useful engine is here.
The next day, Thomas and Tweetsie were getting ready for the first ride of the day as they chucked out of the station. Thomas was amazed with all the new sights of seeing in the Old West. as they came to the village, something was wrong.
Something must be wrong,
thought Thomas.
Where is everybody?
There could be trouble, Thomas. You better hide till to Fort Bone.
I'm not so sure about this. I've heard there could be desperados, and that means bad guys in the Old West.
Thomas was scared, but he knew he had to be brave as they went to Fort Bone. When Thomas and Tweetsie arrived at the fort, they came to a stop, and Thomas knew he had to look out for the red shirt bandits.
Marshal, where are all the troopers? They're supposed to meet us here and take that payroll shipment.
I'm not sure, but those red shirt bandits didn't hear about that payroll shipment.
Red shirt bandits? What do you mean by bandits, Marshal?
Bandits, you know, train robbers, desperados, bad guys!
All right, folks. With these red shirt bandits being around here, I need y'all to be the eyes and ears out here. If you see anything, I need y'all to scream real loud and let us know, okay?
Yeah.
Okay?
Okay!
And that goes
for you too, Thomas. Okay, Sheriff. While they're all busy in that fort, we're gonna help ourselves to that payroll.
Yeah, no!
Cinders and ashes! It's the red shirt bandits! I must let the sheriff know!
Cried Thomas, and he blew his whistle as loudly as he could.
Not even you, Thomas. Quick! Now let's go take care of those mom.
Where'd they go?
Marshal!
Darby! Darby, tell these folks there ain't no bandits inside
nope.
That fort.
Well, I don't know if I can do that.
Wait,
and
wait!
Why not?
Cause there's bandits everywhere!
Thomas, you tell me that's enough, buddy. Suddenly, Thomas heard a whistle. Thomas tooted his whistle, too. The sound came louder and louder, and Thomas gasped.
Well, bust my buffers. Is that one of the troopers, Marshal?
That's no trooper, that's the legendary Blue
Scout. Yeah. Thank you, Thomas. At least someone here knows what they're talking about. I've been watching over Fort Boone while the troopers are out on patrol. Looks like I got here just in time.
That's a pretty
good time. Hey, that horse. It's a real horse.
All right, well, thanks for showing up there, Marshal.
Thomas,
let's get these good folks back home into town.
All righty, well, great job, Thomas. Wait till I tell Sir Top now about here.
Thomas beamed from buffer to buffer. Thomas saved the day.
Well done, Thomas.
Cheers, Tweetsie. Thomas smiled as the pastors cheered and cheered for Thomas the Tank Engine. Thomas felt very proud as he took them back to the station. Sir Top and Pat was there when Thomas arrived.
Sir, what are you doing here?
The sheriff told me that you have saved the day and gave the children a wonderful time too, said Sir Top and Pat. I'm very proud of you, Thomas.
Thank you, sir. But I couldn't have done without my new friend, Tweetsie.
A few weeks later, it was time for Thomas to go home as the Day Out with Thomas event was over.
Thank you for your help, Thomas.
And thank you for inviting me.
Then, it was time for Thomas to go back to Sodor. He whistled farewell to his new friends as he puffed away. As Thomas went back to Sodor, he had a big surprise. All of his friends were there, welcoming him back home at Timoth Sheds.
Thomas, you're back, cried Percy.
It's great to be home again,
smiled Thomas.
And I made a new friend and saved the day too,
added Thomas, and he told his friends all about his big day out at Tweetsie Railroad.